Hello, everyone. Welcome back. This is my third at-home conversation. Today, I'm talking about authentic relationships. Last week, I talked about the difference between authentic love and ego love. According to Meredith Sherry, authentic love is selfless and it involves admiration for a person that doesn't require another person to shift their character traits to be in that person's presence. So when we love authentically, we genuinely want good for other people. And so what we do is we offer our knowledge, our resources to empower them without expecting anything back in return. So it's selflessness. On the other hand, ego love suggests that a person loves to the extent that others give what is expected. Once the other person no longer meets those expectations, the relationship loses its relevance to that person operating from this framework. In this case, love is based on unrealistic expectations because it's conditional rather than unconditional. In the last video, I interjected a statement I often say to our children. Some people make it difficult for you to love them. First, I'm going to go deeper into that, but first I want to share what authenticity is and is not. Authenticity is not doing and being what makes other people comfortable at your own expense. When we are authentic, we share our uniqueness and love for ourselves and others freely. So I want to share a couple of points I gleaned from an article I read written by Harley Therapy. The last three tips really resonated with me because I think we often try to maintain close relational ties with people who don't practice these three fundamental principles I'm going to share, and it creates personal distress. The first one is be responsible for your actions. I'm going to let that sit for a minute. Be responsible for your actions. The second one is commit to respect and kindness. Commit to respect and kindness. The last one, value your relationships, not just what it gives to you. It's hard to show love to people like this. It sounds a lot like ego love. It can lead to anxiety and deep sorrow, particularly when it's family or someone very close. So I'm going to end answering three questions I am often asked. The first one is, you and your husband spent time reflecting and clarifying past and present relationships. Why was that important? At the time, we realized we were not managing our relationships with friends and family well because we had never really taken the time to evaluate them. So we set aside some time where we basically retreated, set aside some time to assess every relationship within close proximity to our family. So how did it help us? We realized we were spending too much time with people who didn't value us or what mattered to us. After taking the time to reflect on that, we discovered the source of our frustration was really the fact that we had to reallocate our time with certain people in our lives. So we learned that we were responsible for managing every aspect of our lives, including relationships. The next question is, what is the greatest lesson you learned from past and present relationships? I learned to be intentional about the people you allow in your circle of influence and make sure your relationships are not misaligned. Set clear relational boundaries with friends and family whose values do not align with yours. So listen, the next video will be my last in this series of at-home conversations. We'll return to community conversations after that. Thank you so much for joining our community, for liking, commenting, subscribing, and sharing. Stay tuned for more content and be courageous enough to evaluate your relationships and unapologetically clear about who should be in your immediate circle. Take good care of yourself.